So hello guys and welcome back to my channel sir. Today in this lecture we will discuss about the Thevenin's theorem sir. So let's start with the statement of Thevenin's theorem sir. We have the statement the current flowing through a resistance RL connected across any two terminals of a network containing one or more sources of current or voltage is given by. Here we have the formula to calculate the Thevenin's current I equals to VTS upon IL plus RTS. And here VTS is the open circuit voltage between the two terminals where RL disconnected, and here RTS is the equivalent resistance of the network with RL removed. And here we have the procedure to calculate the Thevenin's. So in Thevenin's we have some procedure. Altogether we have three procedures, three steps. So first step is to calculate the open circuit voltage, means VTS, across the network terminals. And then after we have to redraw the network with each independent source replaced by its internal resistance. And finally, we have to calculate the RTS, and at the last step, we have to draw the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So let's take one example and see. So in this screen, you can see a question saying we have to calculate the current through these 15 ohm resistors using Thevenin's theorem. So first, we'll remove, means removing 15 ohm resistors, the open circuit voltage between A and B will be. So first, if we remove these 15 ohm resistors, then our circuit will be here. We have 100 volt A and B, means VOC, and here we have 20 ohm, 10 ohm. So the voltage VOC will be VOC equals to, using voltage divider, we can write here 20 upon 20 plus 10 and into this 100 volt. So on calculating, get here 200 upon 3 volt. So Thevenin's equivalent voltage, means VTS, equals to VOC will be 200 upon 3 volt. And then after that, we have to calculate the equivalent resistance, means RTS. So for that, here A, this is, and here now removing the source, we have to remove this 100 volt source, means this 100 volt source will be short circuited, and here we have 10 ohm and 20 ohm, and here we have RTS, or simply you can say RL. So RL will be, means 10 and 20 is in parallel, so 20 into 10 upon 20 plus 10, so you'll get here 20 upon 3 ohm, means RL equals to RTS equals to, we have 20 upon 3 ohms. Then to draw the Thevenin's equivalent circuit, so now we can draw it as here we have voltage source A and B, and here in the question we have 15 ohm resistors and 20 upon 3, this is RTS, and 200 upon 3, this is the VTS, or VOC you can simply write. Now we have to calculate the current through these 15 ohm resistors. So to calculate the current through 15 ohm resistors, we can calculate as, suppose here we have I15, so I15 equals to I15. So for this you can write here, since you know I equals to B upon R, so 200, we have voltage as 200 upon 3 upon R, and R will be the sum of this RTS and this 15, means 20 upon 3 plus 15, so we will get here 3.077 ampere. Hope you got this. Now let's take some more examples. So in this screen you can see a question saying, for the circuit shown in figure, compute the load current using Thevenin's theorem and determine the value of the load for which the power transfer is maximum. So here we have given this circuit. So first we will calculate the Thevenin's equivalent resistance. So calculation of RTS. So to calculate the RTS here, all the current source will be open circuited and the voltage source will be short circuited. So if you open this 3 ampere current source and 2 ampere and again this 2 ampere current source, and this 10 volt and 20 volt voltage source will be short circuited. So our equivalent is this circuit will be this 2 10 and 8 means 2 10 and 8 will be in series. So the value of RTS will be 2 plus 8 plus 2 10 plus 10 we get 20 ohm. And to calculate the VTS we will use the concept of superposition theorems. So using superposition theorems, first we will take this 20 volt current source. So first we have assumed this 20 volt current source, and if you assume this 20 volt source, then the remaining sources, then the remaining voltage source will be short circuited and the remaining current source will be open circuited. So here this 2 ampere and this 3 ampere will be open circuited and this 10 volt will be short circuited. So our equivalent circuit will be this 20 volt, and first we have considered this, so 20 to 10, and again this will be open circuited and 8, and we have in place of 50 we have V1 used here. So we have 20 volt, 2, 10 and 8. So directly you can write here V1 equals to minus 20 volt after taking 20 volt source. And now taking 10 volt source. So if you take 10 volt source, means this 10 volt source, if you take this 10 volt source, then this will be short circuited and this 3 ampere and 2 ampere will be open circuited. So our equivalent circuit will be 2, 10 and 8 will be in series, and here we have assumed V2, but there is no any voltage source. Since this voltage source will right now will not work, so V2 will be directly, so in place of V2 you can directly write V2 equals to 0 volt. Now taking 3 ampere current source. So if you take similarly, if you take 3 ampere current source and the remaining voltage source will be short circuit and the remaining current source will be open circuit, so our equivalent circuit will be, so 2, 10 and 8 again are in the, see here 8 ohm, and here we have 3 ampere current source. So to calculate the value of V3, here we have assumed V3, so 8 into 3 will get here 24 volt. So in place of V3 we have 24 volt, and now we'll take the 2 ampere current source. So if we take this 2 ampere current source, this 3 ampere volt and this 20 volt will be short circuited. So finally our equivalent circuit will be, to here we have 2 ampere, 4 ohm, 10, 8 and 2. So we have assumed here V4. So to calculate the V4, we have this 10 ohm are in parallel with this 2 ampere current source. So you can add here 2 into 10, so 2 into 10 equal to 20 volt. So if you calculate the value of VTS, now VTS will be the sum of V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4. And in place of V1 we have used the value V1 equals to minus 20 volt, plus in place of V2 we have 0, and in place of V3 we have 24, and V4 equals to 20. So finally we will get here 24 volt. Hence the Thevenin's equivalent circuit will be, here we have RL 50 ohm we have here, IL, and this is RTS. So we have 20 ohm RTS and this is VTS, and in place of VTS we have calculated 24 volt. So in place of 20 we have 24 volt, and we have to calculate the value of IL. So to calculate IL you can write here, since IL equals to 24 upon this 20 and 50 are in series right now. So 50 plus 20 will get here 0.343.